Well, now that you know how to get from Kansai or whatever airport to Okayama, from Okayama Station to your various hotels, and how to get around the city, this video will share about how specifically to get to three different key locations for the wedding festivities. There is the shrine for the formal Shinto wedding ceremony, the restaurant Fuyahei, which is the place of the kaiseki fancy lunch afterwards, and finally to Seto Station, where then you'll go to Rural Caprine Farm, the goat farm, for the big party. So, the first stop in our trifecta of important locations is Munetade Shrine. This is where the Shinto ceremony will take place on Saturday, April 20th, with an 11 o'clock start time. You'll want to get there early to take part in a few pre-game rituals, as it were, as well as go by taxi. Your hotel can help you get a taxi, and also we'll have the information written down just in case in Japanese to show to your taxi driver that says, please take me to this shrine. Off the main street, there's a big torii gate that's the main entrance, but the taxi will probably drop you off here in the parking lot where you'll notice a vending machine and a pathway into the grounds. Now, take a few moments to enjoy the grounds because this is really quite spectacular. And if you're so inclined, you can even do a few rituals, including the purification, which means you go to the station and you use a little scoop and you wash your hands to become well purified. Speaking of purified, there's also a toilet and all kinds of other nice grounds and trees to check out. Naturally, there's an arts and crafts component to this activity, which you can purchase one of several different items for like $3 to $5 to $7, and then go to the little station where you can write on it with markers and write a little prayer and then hang it on one of the different racks, you know, extra fun and stuff. Now, this being the solemn ceremony part of the festivities, this is when you get to dress up fancy in your Sunday best, going to grandma's clothes. This is a sacred event for Japanese people, so please dress accordingly. Some of us will be wearing kimonos, that's obviously not required, but do take your time to dress up in something respectable. Then when it's time to begin the ceremony, well, you can go up front and do a and ring the bell, gong gong gong, to wake up your deceased ancestors so they can witness the grandeur of the ceremony. The ceremony itself is a little bit confusing to me. I've done my best to study, but it's going to take about 40 minutes, and it involves a priest saying a bunch of things in formal Japanese, some various other helpers with the ceremony, some ceremonial drinking of sake. Also, we have a limited number of seats and seat assignments, and we're way over. So some of you will have to stand and or sit down on the tatami mats. We're going to do the best to treat everyone like the VIP that you are, but please do keep that in mind and note that we're not trying to divide this up into an A team, B team, but it's just what it is. The whole thing is a little bit confusing, but we're just going to go with the flow. After the ceremony and you put back on your shoes, we'll take advantage of the lovely grounds to take a variety of photographs and enjoy the moment. I might cry a little bit. Then, we have a squadron of 9 taxi cabs coming to take us to the next location, which is Fuyahei Restaurant, where we'll be having a formal kaiseki lunch. The location is great. It's like literally right on the lake. Like if you step out the window, you're in the water. And Okayama Castle and the ramparts are looming overhead. And we're right next to the park, so it's all quite magnificent. This restaurant has been serving guests for 450 years, so we hope they've figured it out by now. And it's going to be, well, interesting to say the least. The taxi will drop you off right here by the prefectural library, one of my favorite locations, and you'll notice kind of a nondescript looking building. You're going to go down this little side road for a couple of steps. You'll see another nondescript sign, and well, you're at the right place. So head on in, take off your shoes, and again, we're going to have to break into 2 groups because we rented out this entire place and we're shoehorning people in, and we had to do some significant convincing to allow admittance of all of you renegades. But there's 2 rooms, and both of them are set up traditional Japanese style and have splendid views of the castle and said ramparts and various trees and lakes and things. Now, kaiseki lunch is a whole bunch of little tiny plates, so we'll take our time and have a leisurely lunch there. And afterwards, well, you'll be kind of on your own. The location is pretty close to go back to the hotels if you're inclined to stroll. Plus, it's right by, well, the lake, obviously, Korakuen Park, as well as Okayama Castle. So it's a great time to go check out those lovely sights in this city. Saturday night, we may have some informal get-togethers, but this is also an opportunity for all of y'all wonderful people to make new friends and make plans on your own. In your welcome packet, there'll be a handy analog map noting out a bunch of restaurants and places to hang out, as well as on the Google map, we've marked a bunch of other restaurants and bar areas and shopping arcades and that kind of thing, so you can make your own adventure. But also, there is a WhatsApp group channel, so please do sign up with that, no complaining, and connect with your new pals for your next adventure. That brings us to Sunday, April 21st, at which point we will switch from serious Shinto ceremony mode to goat farm party mode. This journey will start from you getting to Okayama Station, which you've learned about in previous video, and taking the train to Seto Station. It's about a 20-minute train ride. It'll probably cost you about $3. And again, we'll have a note about what the Seto kanji characters look like. Once you get to Seto Station, well, you'll find yourself out of the city in a lovely rural area, and you can head outside where we'll have a few friends waiting with some signs, some Japanese folks who are going to rally you kids up into different groups and put you into taxis, which we've paid for. As you might expect, in your welcome packet, this will all be in a little handy card that you can take with you, as well as notes in Japanese just in case. These taxis will drive for about 5-7 minutes to get you to Rural Caprine Farm. Not only is this the place I hid out for a few days after running away from the mushroom farm 25 years ago, it's also the place where I met dear Ryoko-san. And the proprietor is the most interesting man in all of Japan, Mr. Matt Kobayashi, who will be preparing his legendary food for us, not necessarily pictured, throughout the course of the event. He also has perhaps the finest record collection anywhere in the known world, let alone just in Japan, which keeps me constantly amused. This place has everything. Hippie children, an espresso machine, original Devo artwork, giant pigs, soft cream ice cream made from goat milk, as well as goats. Lots and lots of goats. And right now, because it's spring, there'll be lots of baby goats. Is there anything cuter than baby goats? And no, these goats do not do yoga. There's also a few different places to hang out and have a little bit of peace and quiet and reflect on your experience in Japan. Now, about the party itself, I can't tell you everything about it because in this video it would be an hour and a half long, but you can dress casual, sharp, fun, and cool, but not jeans, please. Keep in mind that it does get a little bit chilly at night, so probably want to layer up a little bit. The party will start at 2 o'clock, and from 2 o'clock to 6 o'clock, we have various things scheduled, including another wedding ceremony. And you'll say, yeah, well, you already did a ceremony. Well, we actually do three, the formal registration at the city hall, the Shinto shrine ceremony, and then another fun, they're all fun, right? Another ceremony at the party. There'll be a live band, endless food, more than a dozen different types of beverages, dancing, good times, arts and crafts, of course, and over 100 people. So you're going to make all kinds of new friends, and you'll likely go home with a special gift bag. And I say likely because, well, again, we're way over our original number count, so we're doing what we can. Now, the party will go to whenever the trains run till about 10:30 or 11. We're going to have two different announcers, one in Japanese, one in English, emceeing the events, and they'll be putting out notifications about people who can give people a ride to a station, as well as we can have taxis come and pick up as needed. Now, some of you will be going early to help set up, thank you for that, and staying over for a day or two or three at the goat farm. Mr. Kobayashi has a lovely house he's allowed us to utilize. I tell you, he's really the best guy. And we're going to set it up just big dorm hostel style, so if you're seeking privacy, this is not your option. But we can fit a gaggle of people there, and we'll stock up the fridge with some extra food so Mac doesn't have to cook for everyone. And you can spend the Monday, if you so choose, hanging out at the farm, playing with the goats, saying hello to the pigs. There's a miniature horse. There's rabbits. There's birds. It's a really special place to me, so I hope you enjoy it as well. Once we're done the party, the formal scheduled part of the weekend's festivities will conclude, and most of you will be staying on for several days, which is awesome because there's so much to do around here. As for me, though, I'm going to need Monday as a rest and recovery day. It's just the way my body works right now. But in the Google Doc, and with all the new friends you've found and the research you've done, no doubt, there's no shortage of things to do. Both in town in Okayama, where we've marked out all kinds of restaurants, shopping streets, and then there's an incredible assortment of museums right in Okayama City. A short train ride away are the towns of Bizen, which is one of six ancient traditional pottery centers and also has a sword museum, and then Kurashiki. And Kurashiki is an old trading village going back to the olden days and has another incredible assortment of museums, including the remarkable Ohara Museum, which has a stunning collection of Impressionist and Post-Impressionist European art in a small, quaint museum like, whoa, Picasso, Monet, and all the likes. So a little short train adventures there. Also, you can take a day trip easily to Hiroshima or Kyoto, each about 40 minutes to an hour by bullet train. There's no explanation needed to say what the splendors await you in those cities. Also, around Okayama City, there's our hidden favorite okonomiyaki place, as well as just great food everywhere. The thing to remember about food is you may not know what it is, but nothing they serve in restaurants is technically poisonous. So, well, puffer fish, don't get pedantic on me. So enjoy yourself. My intention is on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, etc., we'll break into some different groups and head off on some different little adventures depending on size and people's interests and schedules and that kind of stuff. Of course, 25 of y'all coming, it's hard to call everyone at once, I'm not much of a cat herder, but hopefully we'll do some trips to maybe some hot springs, maybe some museums, roll on some trains, check out some gardens and some scenery, or just find a lovely tree to sit under and have a picnic. That said, it's my hope that with you 25 wonderful people coming out for this adventure, you make new friends with common interests, head out on adventures, and have the most splendid time here in Japan. I'm super excited to share my new home with you, and hopefully the documents, the maps, the videos, and the WhatsApp channel will answer most of your questions and keep the communication rolling fondly, Kamadave.